It's game day, everybody. So we are going to make apple nachos. Alright, so this recipe, super easy. You don't need to cook anything. All you need is a lot of creativity because you're going to make a masterpiece. Okay, so let's look at what we need for this recipe. We have two apples here, and we chose to mix it up with some colors. So we got a red apple and a yellow apple. We have dried blueberries, some chocolate chips, coconut flakes, walnuts, dried cranberry, a little bit of granola, pumpkin seeds, chia seeds, and peanut butter, and that's all for the toppings, okay? And then we're also going to make a yogurt sauce, and the ingredients for the yogurt sauce are yogurt, a little bit of honey, and also we're going to use some of this dried fruit and then put it in a food processor and blend it all up. And you'll need a cutting board and a knife as well. Okay, first things first, we're going to chop the apples. So first, I chop it in half. Chop it in quarters. Then you want to cut out the core piece with this like diagonal cut right here. Okay, and then for this particular recipe, we want really thin slices. Okay, and then once all our apples are sliced, we're gonna arrange them on the plate. You can arrange them however you like. You can make a spiral, you can make a star, you can make the shape of an apple, go crazy. The shape of a football, who knows? You know, it's game day after all. Okay. So when you're done, maybe you'll have something that looks kind of like
okay, that. Now we're going to make the yogurt sauce. So first measure out a quarter cup of yogurt.
And I have a little food processor here, but you can use a blender. You can use a normal sized food processor. Okay. And then the recipe calls for a quarter cup of dried fruit. Today we're actually going to use a little blueberry compote that I made last night. So, but yeah, if you're using dried fruit, you may want to pre-soak your dried fruit in the yogurt for a couple hours before you want to blend it. That way it'll be more smooth. But these are already nice and wet, so it'll blend really smooth. All right, and then you'll know it's done when it changes color and it's creamy and smooth. Okay. Set our yogurt sauce aside real quick and do a little drizzling of nut butter. And I just heated this up in the microwave for about 20 seconds just to get it a little bit runnier. Okay, then you want to drizzle on your yogurt sauce. Then you want to add all of your dry ingredients, your toppings. Crunch. So the key to good apple nachos is a bunch of different textures, a bunch of different colors, and a bunch of different flavors. So just remember that, and you can't go wrong with your toppings. Okay, so there you have it. There's apple nachos.
Let's give it a try.
Wow.
Mm-hmm. That's good. I'm going to have another piece.
This is so good. It's like, it's kind of like having apples and peanut butter as a snack, but next level for sure. Okay. Thanks for joining us. We'll see you next time. Take care.
And she's going in for the long shot. She shoots and she scores. You're not going to believe this one. Bucks, that is 1 point for Cooper up on the score.